Hello and welcome to this National Fostering Group virtual event. I'm Helen and today we're going to be talking to Casey, one of our lovely team from Fostering Solutions. If you were to apply to become a foster carer, she's the type of person that you can expect to speak to. She's absolutely lovely. I can't wait for you to meet her. Now, if you are watching this live via Facebook, you can add a comment or a question below, or you can send us a direct private message. If you're watching this back on our website or on YouTube and you have a question about becoming a foster carer, please don't hesitate to give us a call, 0330 022 9135. You'll see that number on the screen now. So let's say hello to Casey. Hi, Casey.
Hi, everyone.
Hi, Casey. Thank you so much for joining us today. So firstly, Casey, I've got to reference the lovely background that you're sitting in front of. Please tell us about that. It looks lovely.
This is part of the things we do with our children. So this is part of our children's participation events. So the rainbow that we've got just up here, that's a rainbow of dreams. That's all of our children's kind of aspirations for when they grow up. We've got things like vets, policemen. One of them wants to be a social worker, which is really fantastic, so they can come along and join us. And then the tree on this side is a tree of hope. So the idea is that the branches grow, so it's full of all the things they really like at the moment. So some of them are really simple, like cake. Others are foster carers. And then as they get older, those kind of things that they're enjoying grow. So that it's about watching their journey. So they come back into the office, they can see what they put on there a few months ago or last year. So it's really nice.
Oh, Casey, that's gorgeous. Thank you so much for sharing that with us. So please do tell us more about your role. What is it that you do?
So I'm part of a larger team here, made up of social workers and support workers. I'm the carer recruitment officer. So I guide people through their journey to become a foster carer. So often at the start of their journey, it'll be me that you speak to. I answer their questions. And then another aspect of my role is to support our foster carers and our fostering families. So I get involved in lots of like participation events and support groups.
Okay, so what sort of questions do people ask you, and how many questions do you get? Do you get a lot of people asking about fostering?
Yeah, we do get a lot of inquiries. They range really. I always say there's no such thing as a silly question, because if it's your question, it's your question. You need an answer for it. So some people prefer to kind of email and type questions out, because I guess that's slightly less daunting than phoning. So sometimes we get questions in via email. Sometimes people text, and they have a range of questions. A common question we would get would be about pets is a big one, particularly if someone's got a rare pet. We had one the other day about a snake, and I'm really glad they told me before I went and did an initial visit, because I'm a bit scared of snakes, but for us that wasn't a problem. So we get questions particularly about people that are in same-sex couples. And they're very worried about how that impacts on the children. So what we do is we'll pop them in touch with a foster carer that does that, that is in a same-sex relationship and fosters with us, so that they can really kind of truly see what it's like on the ground. So we get lots of questions. I think it's really important that to know that when you ask a question to us, that's not you starting your journey with us. There's no pressure after that. We completely do it at your pace. Which I think some people don't realise, so they're a bit scared to kind of come forward and ask a question, thinking that's the start of their application, but it's absolutely not. We speak to people for kind of up to a year, really, sometimes, and I'll meet up with them for a cup of tea every now and then, or we'll buddy them up with a foster carer, or they just want to stay in touch and get a bit of information and come back to us, and that's fine.
Yeah, it's so good to hear that it's nice and informal at first. You know, it's not daunting. And also that, as you say, there's lots of different ways to get in touch, whatever you're comfortable with, whether that's a phone call or whether that's a text. Yeah. So, Casey, I'd like to hear a little bit about more about you and why you wanted to become a carer recruitment officer. What was it that spurred you on to do that?
So I've always wanted to be a part of changing children's lives, and fostering changes everyone's life. It changes foster carers' lives and it changes the children's life. It's truly an amazing thing to do, and to be part of that is really, really special. I'm an adoptive mum, so I adopted two boys, two siblings. So I've been through a really, well, an identical journey to our foster carers go through. It was really important for me to make sure that people's journey was really positive. So I can kind of tweak the parts of my journey that perhaps, you know, needed improving and pass that on. So I'm really passionate about making sure everyone has a positive beginning.
Yeah, that's lovely that there's such a personal motivation for you there for doing your job. It's a real passion for you. What would you say is your favourite part of the job? Could you pinpoint one thing, Casey?
Well, I truly love my job. So this is a really difficult question to have an absolute favourite. I love being around the children. So I love doing, when I come out and do a home visit, for example, if your children are there, that's really amazing for me because I can bring them in and kind of give them information, particularly with teenagers. Sometimes we sit there and we watch the football for a minute and they're not always keen to talk to me straight away. But if I kind of drop a little bit of information about the football team that they're talking about, they then come along and then that's their opportunity as well to ask me questions. Sometimes I leave my little card on the coffee table and I say to them, give me a text if you've got any questions, because I know that, again, that they prefer to kind of message, and we do, that they perhaps don't want to come to their parents and ask them because their parents are obviously really keen to foster. It's an opportunity to kind of involve them. And that's a kind of a part of my job I really like, to kind of include the whole family in this fostering journey.
Yeah, it sounds incredibly rewarding, Casey. Sounds like a perfect job for you, it really does. So we touched on this a little bit earlier, but in case people are just tuning in now, what would you say are the most common things that potential foster carers ask? You know, those things that they might think, well, I can't foster because of this. You know, what are the main things?
So one of the questions we commonly get asked is about people that don't speak English as their first language. Or there might be two of them in the home and they speak a different language in the home, and how that works in terms of fostering and having a foster placement. And this is an area we heavily work. We have social workers that will come in and they'll work with the family on their understanding. And it really is about us supporting you. So things like if you've got good verbal English but your written English isn't quite as good, we can help you with your application form, and we can help you with the skills that you need to become a foster carer in terms of the paperwork side of things. So that's a common question we get asked, and people are kind of, often most people are better than they think they are, and it's just a kind of confidence thing. So that's something we get asked a lot. Quite a lot of people are a little bit worried about the technical side of fostering and how to kind of do their application form, how to meet, because our support groups at the moment are online, how they do that. And so they're worried about that side of fostering as well. So that's a common question we're getting asked at the moment, whereas before lockdown, we never kind of had to deal with those type of things. And again, I'll come along and log you on, help with application forms. We can do most of it over the phone. So a lot of that's done for you. But we also get asked a lot of questions, like I mentioned before, about people that maybe a single male applicant is a big one we get. I always say to everyone, rule yourself in, ask the question, because if you rule yourself out, it's an automatic no, isn't it? Because you haven't even kind of approached it. Whereas if you rule yourself in, we will work with you. We want you to become foster carers. We've got lots and lots of children out there from very, very different backgrounds. We need lots of foster carers from very, very different backgrounds. So yeah, rule yourself in.
Yeah, that is a great phrase. It really is. And another thing that we touched on before was pets as well, wasn't it? We actually did a whole session on pets, which you'll be able to find on our website. And I think sometimes people think if they've got a big dog or whatever, that's it, they can't foster. But that's not the case, is it?
Absolutely not. So what happens is I'll come out and do a home visit, and I get the chance to meet your pets then, which is a great opportunity for me to meet them, see how friendly they are, look at things like kind of how in control you are of them. So if you've got three large dogs and I knock on the front door and they come jumping up to me and I give them a pat and you say, oh, down, you know, that to me shows that, you know, you've got that level of understanding that even though I'm very friendly with pets, not everyone that comes to your door might be. So it's those kind of things. We have foster carers with a big farms and they've got lots of pets and the children just, they think it's amazing. It's a great icebreaker when they first come into your house. Often our children gauge from your reaction to your pets how they're going to be treated in the home. So they particularly like it if your pet's a little bit cheeky, we should say, because if you've got a dog that maybe kind of takes a sock and goes and hides it, and you know your approach to that is very friendly and you laugh it off and you're like, oh no, Jack's got the sock again, come on, let's go and put this in the laundry basket, they can tell then that, you know, when they make a mistake and they do something wrong, that that's going to be your reaction. So it's a great icebreaker, pets are. There really is no kind of set thing with pets. It very much is about you and your pets and your individual circumstances. So always approach us. Like I said, we've got people with snakes and we just kind of make sure that they're in a lockable cabinet and we just ask the questions. Anyone that's going to put a child in the house would ask, can a child get the snake out when you're in the bathroom? Those kind of things. Yeah. It really is individual and it's just about having those open conversations with us so that we can tweak that.
Yeah, as you say, it is individual. Every situation is different and rule yourself in. Really, really like that. And if you're watching now and you do want to find out more about fostering with pets, as I say, we did do a session on that. It's on our Facebook, on our YouTube, on our website. So do go and have a look at that. So if anyone was watching now and they're thinking about fostering, Casey, what would you say to them? Rule yourself in?
Definitely rule yourself in. It's an amazing thing to do. Even if you're not quite ready, it's a fantastic thing to kind of reach out to our community. We're a really close-knit community and there's so many people here that will talk to you. So our foster carers will talk to you. We've got children that like advocating for fostering. So they'll talk to you. We've got birth children that are really passionate about speaking to other birth children. So they're normally teenagers and they'll tell your children what it's like to be a child in the home of a fostering family. So reach out to us, there's a wealth of information out there and we're more than happy to share it, even if you're not ready.
Yeah, absolutely. And there's loads of ways to get in touch. The phone number and the website are on our screen and you can send us a direct message through Facebook as well. So a couple of questions that have come in from people watching, Casey. Are there carer recruitment offices everywhere and how can I find one near to me? So someone like you, how would we find someone like you?
Yes, we're all over the country. We're all super friendly. We're all really people.
People.
So if you go to our website, they'll put you in touch with your local agency and then your carer recruitment officer will give you a ring.
Okay, wonderful. And another question here, do I have to have special qualifications to foster?
Absolutely not. That's one of the fantastic things about fostering. Whoever you are and whatever's happened in your past, you can come forward and we will give you the skill sets you need to foster. So we've got an amazing training package and we will guide you and support you to become a foster carer. So you don't need any skill sets from the beginning.
Yeah, lots of guidance and support. And this leads nicely into the next question, actually. How do the National Fostering Group stay in touch with and support their foster carers?
So once you become a foster carer with us, like I said, we're a very close-knit community. So here at Fostering Solutions South and all of our agencies have lots of events going on. So we run some formal support groups, which at the moment are happening virtually, but normally they'd happen at kind of a hotel, just a chance to get together with other foster carers in your local area, have a bit of a chat and a cup of tea and kind of offload. That's a kind of key part of fostering, I think, to be around other families in a similar situation. We've got lots of fun events going on. We do a big summer barbecue. We do fostering fun. which is a support group for our fostering families to kind of bond together. So we do lots of different activities, play lots of games. So all of our families are welcome to come along to that. So whether you've got a placement at the moment or you're in a parent and child placement, they're all geared up so that you can help people. So you can join in with other families and go on their teams to make friends. There's lots of things to be involved in. And then, of course, we do have our social workers that support our foster carers on the ground. So they're very much still in the families' homes. They're going out and visiting them, and they'll be there on the phone and in person for you. So they do a visit once a month. If you've got a new placement, that they'll come in once a week and support you. So there's always someone at the end of the phone or in person.
Yeah, it's so lovely to hear that it is such a lovely family and that there is loads of support available, as you say. So thank you so much, Casey. It has been lovely to meet you today. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
Thanks, Casey. And thank you to you for watching. If you would like to roll yourself in and become part of the fostering family here at the National Fostering Group, there's loads of ways to get in touch. If you're watching it back on Facebook, you can send us a direct message or comment on this video. You can visit our website, which is on the screen, nfa.co.uk/fostering events, or give us a call and somebody lovely like Casey will have a chat with you. It's 0330 022 9135. We've got loads of fantastic events coming up, so please visit the events section of our website so you don't miss out, and on the Facebook page as well. So we'll see you again soon. Thank you. Bye.